Hello everybody, myself Professor Dr. K. Gayathri Devi, working at Dr. NGP Institute of Technology, Coimbatore. Today's my topic will be on basics of signals and systems. Now what are signals? Signals are the variables that carry information, and you have different types of signals such as motion, sound, picture, video, traffic, light. And what is a system? System is nothing but an assembly of entities or the objects which will be connected together to produce a specific output signal. So here you have a system which is here, an image is given as an input to a system. It produces an output image. So the system does the process of brightening the image, increasing the contrast of the image, color of the image, and so on. So different types of systems we have. Natural systems, human-made systems, abstract systems, and so on. So before going into the details of the different types of elementary signals, let me first define the signals and the systems in detail. Signals are nothing but the functions of independent variable. Functions of independent variables will include time t for a one-dimensional signal. So based on the number of independent variables used, we have different types of signals: one-dimensional signals, two-dimensional signals, and so on. System will respond to the input signal, and they will process the input signal, and they will produce an output signal. So here I have given you an example of a one-dimensional signal, where the x-axis is the independent variable time and the y-axis is the amplitude of the signal. And this is the spectrum of the signal which is shown in this figure. So this diagram will give you the one-dimensional signal example. And the previous diagram is a continuous signal, and now it is a discrete signal where the signals are defined only at integer values of the time. And we have an example for a two-dimensional signal. Two-dimensional signal means you require two independent variables. For example, one x value and one y value is needed to define any particular point in an image. So it is an example or a two-dimensional signal. And let me first give you the practical examples of signals and the systems. For example, an automobile driver driving the car will press the accelerator. So here the system is nothing but the automobile, and the pressure that is given on the pedal is the input signal, and based on the pressure that is given, the speed of the automobile will vary. So it is nothing but the response or the output signal. The second signal is the digitalized ECG signal, which is given as the input to the computer program. So this computer program will calculate the heartbeat of the patient. Hence the system here is a computer program. ECG signal is the input signal. The calculation of the heart rate will be the output signal. And you have given you a third practical example in which you have a camera which will record the input image, and this camera will process this image and it will produce an output image. So here system is the camera, the light is the input signal, and the photograph of the film is the response or the output signal. So first, how do we represent signal in a graphical format or a mathematical format? So to represent a signal in a graphical format, you require x value and a y value. Here x value is called as a time or an independent variable, and the y axis is nothing but the dependent variable or the amplitude. First, coming to the major classifications. First, continuous time signals and discrete time signals are the most important classification a student must know before entering into the signals and systems. So what is continuous signal? A signal that has a value defined for all points in time, which is represented as x of t. Here t is the independent variable, and x of t is nothing but the representation. Commonly found in the physical world is, example, a human speech, and this is the graphical representation of a signal. An analog signal we have. Human voice is a best example of an analog or a continuous signal. We have AM radio signal, FM radio signals. And next one, what is a discrete time signal? discrete time signals is normally represented by an independent variable n, and the y-axis will be represented by x of n. Here, discrete signals will be defined only for integer values of n, meaning the values are defined only at n is 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. X of n will be continuous in nature, meaning it can take 0.1, 0.2, 1, 3 and so on. So this graph here will give you the digital signal, discrete signals. Next one is a digital signal. Third major classification. What is a digital signal? Here both x-axis and y-axis will be discrete in nature and you will have either zeros or one. So this is a figure which has been taken from the MATLAB software. An example for a continuous signal x of t, and we have a discrete signal x of n. So x of t is defined for all values of time and x of n is defined only for integer values 0, 1, 2 and so on. Now coming to analog or digital. So I have given you as to just a recap, analog message is nothing but continuous in amplitude and over time. So it is AM and FM for voice recording. Traditional TV is used as analog video, first generation cell phone and record player. All these are the examples for the analog message. Digital message, we have VCD, DVD, 2G, 3G cellular phone and data on your disk. And I have given you a description of the advantages and the disadvantages of the analog versus digital. Now coming to the main major topic of elementary signals. First one, continuous unit impulse and the step signal. So first signal is the continuous unit impulse signal. As the name states, your amplitude will be unity. And your impulse signal is a signal which is defined only for one values of time. So here, for the value of time t is equal to 0, the value is 1. And for all the other values, the value will remain 0. So the graphical representation is given in the figure. For the value of 0, the amplitude is 1. And for all the other values of time, here the amplitude is 0. And this is a shifted version which will be dealt later. And next one is a continuous unit step signal. As the name itself tells you, it will take you a staircase waveform or a step. So here unit step signal is defined only for positive values of t, and for negative values of t the value is 0. So this is a mathematical representation for a unit step signal which is defined as u of t, which takes the value 1 for t greater than or equal to 0, and it is 0 for t less than 0. So unit step signal is defined only for positive values of t, and for negative values of t it takes a value 0. Next one is a ramp function. It's like a staircase. So u of ramp function is defined as ramp of t. It is nothing but a t for t greater than or equal to 0 and 0 for t less than 0. So when you have value 0, it is 0. If you put it as 1, the output will be 1. So on plotting of the different values over t, you will get signal as a linear function. Next one is a discrete signal. How do you convert a continuous to a discrete? By a process called as a sampling. Sampling is nothing but acquisition of the values of a CT signal at discrete instant of time. As I've told you previously, continuous signal is represented by x of t and discrete signals is represented by x of n. So now coming to the discrete time unit impulse function. Previously, we had represented it as del of t. Now, since it is discrete, del of n. So, del of n will take the value 1 at n is equal to 0. And for all the other values of n, it will take the value 0. And next one is a discrete time unit step function. Now, the difference between continuous and discrete is that it is defined in discrete. It is defined only at integer values of n. So, 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. So u of n takes value 1 for all positive values of n and it takes value 0 for all negative values of n. And unit ramp function, as I've told you, ramp function is defined as ramp of n is equal to n for n greater than or equal to 0. So for value of 0, you will get value is 0. When I say for ramp of 1, when I put n is 1, here it is 1. So it is plotted, and for 2 it is 2, for 3 it is 3, and for 4 it is 4, and for 8 it is 8. So it is nothing but a linear waveform. And next one, we have the relation between a unit pulse, unit impulse and a step signal. So del of n represent impulse, u of n represents unit step. So the given below is the relation between a unit impulse and a unit step. And the fifth category of the classification is the exponential and the sinusoidal signal. Exponential signals are represented as x of t is equal to c into e power at. So for when I substitute time t is equal to 0, e power 0 is equal to 1. Hence an exponential signal will start from 1, which as I have shown in this figure, and for different values of c, whether it takes a real number or a complex number, and for the values of a, which takes a real or a complex number, you will have different types of exponential signal. First one is the real exponential signal, meaning when both c variable and the a variable takes real values. So when a is greater than 0 and c is greater than 0, we'll have a growing exponential. And when a is less than 0 and for c greater than 0, it will be a decaying exponential signal. You can find out the graph, how it is shown, by putting assigning a suitable value of a, such as a is equal to 2, and substituting different values of t. And so you can find different values of x of t and plot the graph. You will get a graph as shown in this figure. And next one, as I have told you, when I put different values of c and a, here c is a real and a is a complex number. Complex number means instead of a, I have put as j omega naught. So e power j omega naught will be cos omega naught t plus j sin omega naught t, and you will get a graph like this. And you have the third category, when both c is complex and a is also a complex. So we'll have a damped sinusoidal signal as shown in this figure. So here c is in polar form, a is in rectangular form. And the next category of elementary signal is the signum function, represented as sgn of t. Here it takes a value 1 for t greater than 0 and minus 1 for t less than 0. And the next classification of signal is a rectangular pulse or a gate function, where the signal will exist only from minus a by 2 to plus a by 2, it has a value 1 by a, and for all the remaining values of t, its value is 0. And the next function or the signal is a unit triangular signal, a triangular pulse whose height and the area are both 1, but its base width is not, is called as a unit triangular function. And the last function is a sing function, which is mostly used in communication related concepts. Sing function is represented as sinc of t. It is nothing but equal to sine pi t by pi t. And here you have a sing function in which this is called as a main lobe, and all the decaying portion is called as a side lobe, and most of the energy will be concentrated only in this main lobe. And the zero crossing points will be at n is 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. I hope this lecture has given you an introduction on the different types of signals, such as unit impulse, pulse, sinc function, signum function, exponential, periodical and so on. My next lecture will be on the transformations of the independent variable. Thank you.